Hi everyone, welcome to Cast. My name's Ottimo, and this is going to be a soon-to-be 4v5 game. Someone submitted this on Reddit and said it's going to be an epic 4v5 game, so I'm kind of hoping it comes true. Let's look at the two teams. We'll start with the Dire side. On the Dire side, we have the Kark on Clockwork, Nat's Ghoul on the Tiny, Vico on Crystal Maiden, we have Papa Dios on the Weaver. Oh my god, he takes Jiminy Tech level 1. And lastly, who's left? Ricky Mar being played by Nayarp. Oh, this is so bad. Anyway, let's look at the Radiant side. Radiant side, we have Sweet Pea on the Legion Commander, Drunken Thunder on the Shadow Shaman, Enigma being played by Minster. We're mixed by a Hell of Fan Elk? Of an Elk? Ah, Hell of an Elk. And Pudge being played by Irish Chef. So, I want to just go quickly and say that level 1 Weaver, you really don't want to take Jiminy attack. What do you get exactly? A couple of extra hits? If you take Shikuchi, you get magic damage, which is, you know, easier to last hit with if you want. You can harass, and you also get a really good escape mechanism. So I really don't see why he took this. And Crystal Maiden actually takes the Bounty Ruin. The hook from Pudge comes out, but actually kind of was blocked by the Rikimaru. Crystal Maiden taking the... Oh wait, bottom lane, we have engagement here. Nyx Assassin, is he okay? He can stun if he wants to. He definitely should stun. The Tiny doesn't have enough mana for anything, but Nyx Assassin just running away. He doesn't realize that... Oh, there you go. Doesn't realize that both of these people move much faster with him. Both of them have boots and he doesn't. Not sure why he didn't just stun them and run away, but he decided to instead panic, I guess, and look what happened from that. This is an unranked game, by the way, and I'm not really sure what's the skill level. But we're gonna find out pretty soon. Looks like top lane is gonna be an Enigma offlane. Looks like he's just going to be converting creeps and Weaver. How's he gonna do against Enigma? Oh, taking quite a lot of damage right now. Man, if only he had an ability that could make him go Envy, so he wouldn't take any damage. Is there such an ability in the game for Weaver that makes him go invisible? I wonder. He's gonna go up with a Shao Shaman, also going to be pretty tough, really for the Weaver, I think. In general, I mean, if he had Shikuchi, it'd be easy. Oh, wow! Oh, level 2! The Swarm! Interesting. Very interesting. Come on, dude, please, for the love of God, give me a Shikuchi point here. Come on. I'm rooting for you here. Forget it. This lane is lost for the Weaver. Unless the Enigma massively misplays. He stuns a creep. There's some really weird stuff going on in this game, I tell you. There's something odd. Nyx Assassin's bottom lane. Who's he with anyways? He's solo? Oh, he's going with the Legion Commander. It looks like they're going to be doing okay. Focusing more on harassing than CS for some reason. Mid lane is going to be the Pudge. Pudge against the Crystal Maiden, as well as an Envy Rikimaru supporting her, apparently. Pudge versus Crystal Maiden, the classic matchup. Mid, who's going to win it? Crystal Maiden finally puts a point in her Arcane Arrow, so it's going to help her spam out her spells a little bit. So far, it seems like Crystal Maiden is actually beating the Pudge. Have you ever heard that line before? Crystal Maiden beating Pudge in mid lane? I haven't. I've never said it before, but this game is quite interesting. Enigma kills the Weaver. Let's go see how that happened. Takes a stun. And there we go. Just a couple of creatures hitting him. There we go. If only he had actually killed the bugs that were on him the entire time, but decides not to do that for some reason. Alright, so I'm beginning to think that this game may not be the most high-skilled game. Mid lane, looks like he might fall. Dive into tower. Come on, dude, you could have just rotted a bit sooner. Crystal Maiden taking a few tower shots, might? Nope, close enough. One more hit would have killed her, but she does make it out alive. How's bottom lane looking? Next assassin. No points in the spite Karapachi, but that's no big deal, really. You could take a level, one point in every level, or you can take a level 4, no big deal. I prefer to take a level 2 and mana burnt level 4, but this is fine as well. They're harassing the clockwork pretty nicely. Most of the time, you see Enigma going to the jungle, but for some reason, this Enigma decides not to do that. He also has a skill point that he's not using yet. Oh, well, time will tell. Wow, okay, this is quite an interesting game. I didn't expect it to be so different than what I usually cast. Shadow Shaman. I like his skill build, Shackles, as well as Aether Shock. I've been playing with Shadow Shaman quite a lot lately, and I've noticed that his Shackles is just a really good spell. I mean, the damage increases, the duration increases, just good stuff bottom lane. And it looks like they'll be okay. Enigma starting to go to the jungle, very nice for him. it's also means that the Shadow Shaman is going to be solo top lane. Oh dear, let's see what happened there. Looks like Pudge just diving in. Crystal Maiden has a full mana pool, has two spells, misses the Frost Nova, doesn't use Bite, and dies. You know, sometimes people are like, what could I have done more in the game? And you're like, well, you could have, you know, survived a very easy situation. But, well. So yeah, Shadow Shaman gets to solo top lane. He can actually, he doesn't have any mana regen, that's the problem. Also, they don't have any courier on, well, they do have a courier on the dire side, that's surprising. But yeah, he doesn't have, they don't have any courier. He has two wards, but no courier. I feel like the courier is more important than the two wards, but either way, if he plants one, that'll be kind of useful. Regen Ruin will be very helpful for him. Come on, you're so close to it. Oh, wait, no. No need? Oh, okay. Gives it to the... Ah, very nice. Gives it to the Pudge. What a nice guy. I like that. How's Enigma doing? Enigma has the Midnight Pulse. If anyone here is an Enigma player, just be sure that you know that you can use Midnight Pulse to cut down the trees here to jungle faster. You can use it to cut down the trees here to jungle these two camps as well. So if you're raising, if you're the other side, you should cut down these trees as well as these trees here. So you can jungle between camps very easily. You don't have to waste time instead of, you know, walking all around from one side to the other. You can just straight away go to a creep camp. You know, just Enigma things. What was Nyx Assassin doing? Alright, I like this. I like the items, I like the skill build. They actually have a flying courier now on the Radiant side. Alright, 2 seconds ago they didn't have a courier at all. Oh, you might have engagement here. Smoke does come out. They're just all standing in the smoke. Enigma walks into the smoke. Come on, Enigma. There we go. Now they're trying to go for someone. Alright, they want to go for the time, but they can't actually get him. And I don't think anyone's going to fall in this engagement, really, from the dire side. Maybe? No. Nothing's going to happen. Just kind of, everyone just kind of lumbers their way to safety. Not surprising. Meanwhile, apparently Pudge killed the Crystal Maiden and committed suicide. Not really sure if he needs to commit suicide, but didn't see what happened. Let's see, Pudge, what's he gonna go for? Was this an urn maybe? Power Tres? Not really sure exactly what he wants. Top lane. It's a hard life if you're the Shadow Shaman. Not sure if he needs the Hex, if it's gonna be very useful, but we'll find out soon enough. The Dire have two Envy here, so I'm wondering if we're gonna see sentries coming out from the rain. I think there's someone. Yeah, Pudge does have sentries. Misses the hook by quite a bit, actually. That's somewhat unexpected. And Enigma is leading the last hit boards at 24 last hits, most of them being jungle creeps, so they're not the most valuable. I will say, though, that in a game like this, I mean, you should have more last hits. So not in a game like this, but in general, we have 7 CSs, the highest at 6 minutes. That's 1 CS a minute almost. That's pretty damn terrible. The only people who are doing well in CS... bomb lane, looks like someone just got killed. The only people who are doing well in CS are the Enigma and the Weaver. And Enigma is doing well in CS because literally no one else can contest him in the forest. And Weaver is just kind of solo the whole time. His skill build is slightly better now that he has 2 points. He should have maxed out by level 7. And he's playing so passively as well. That's another thing that he's... I mean, what, you really think the Swarm is going to do a lot of harass? It's not. Swarm is one of the worst scaling abilities in the game. It's pretty good level 1, of course. It gives you a lot of good things. Minus armor, vision, and damage. But just throwing it out and giving the enemy gold is not going to help. Pudge, meanwhile, might be in trouble. No hookshot is available. Okay, that's about it. Crystal Maiden also wasn't able to do much. Tranquil boots mid lane, not the best boots because you're not going to do much damage with them. She could spam out the Frostbite on any creep and get a kill. Meanwhile, top lane Weaver is able to drop the tower. Very good job by him. Pudge, can he land that hook? Can he thread the needle, as they say? It's pretty hard, actually. I mean, especially nowadays because hook actually affects the siege creeps. Before, the hook you just pass through them, but now the game is a bit harder. He missed one creep, he missed the other creep. Pudge with 7 CS against the Crystal Maiden's 8. What is this game? Oh my god. Nyx Assassin finally has his arcane boots, also has his ulti. So he's fine, so they already now have some envy on their side if they need it. Oh, wait. Oh, sorry, nothing happened. I changed it just as the fight begins. Legion Commander, is she gonna be okay? Does take a bit of damage. Nice double stun coming out. Looks like she's gonna be okay. Doesn't actually have any points to press the attack for the extra HP that, you know, would be really useful. Pudge, Nyx Assassin might be in a bit of trouble. Does have the spike Karapachi. Uses it a bit late, but no big deal. He looks like he wasn't gonna fall anyway. gold experience favor upgraded by 1k gold in favor of the Dire. I'm surprised that there's been so many kills. I've missed too much. Meanwhile, it looks like Weaver's just gone middle to help push this lane. Still sticking to that max Jimmy detect. I swear, this guy's skill build is all over the place. Man, I don't know. I'm a huge Weaver player. Weaver's like my second most played here. I have like 150 games on the guy. So when I see him played badly, it physically hurts me. Well. Does have good items though. Magic Wand, Tranquil Boot, Ring of Aquila, and Power Treads. All of these are really good stuff. You know, top lane looks like Nico's gonna help push. This lane should do okay. Oh, come on, Crystal Maiden, get your act together. Crystal Maiden is 0-4 now after this kill. Every few seconds I find out that she's dead. Ah, dear. Bomb lane, are they gonna be able to get this tower? Alright, next assassin is Envy. Who's he gonna go for? Ricky has 2 ways of Envy, so he needs to catch him pretty early once he reveals himself, because he only has like 6 seconds, not that bad. Vision Commanders, he doesn't have her ultimate. And Weaver's a pretty hard kill. Oh, they need to focus. I think the Tiny is the easier kill. Can they get it? Stun does land. Beautiful stun. She does throw out a good sentry ward. Can they get him? They don't have duel to lock him down. And the courier's here. Can they land the stun? The bug is doing so much work. Look at him. -10 armor now from the Weaver bug. And looks like he's gonna fall. He had spiked carapace, but decided not to use it for some reason. And ultimate action comes out from the clockwork, doesn't do anything. Crystal Maiden dies again for some reason. And the top lane, Crystal Maiden, what is this? This is 0-5 Crystal Maiden. This is the classic support Crystal Maiden that you see in every game. You know, I'm gonna support the team, and then they do absolutely nothing for the whole game. Well, was she the one impeded by the courier? And I think that's the support these days. I bought the courier. You know, you can't flame me anymore, despite the fact that I've died once every 2 minutes so far. These days in Dota, it seems like, you know, someone, if they do a bit of their job, they're suddenly bragging. Actually, it's the nice. Can you get it? He does have time-lapse. There we go. Now he uses it. And it looks like Nyx Assassin probably, he can actually walk into a spike care base, comes out, and Nyx Assassin is gonna fall. Nice presence of mind to use, this time lapse when he needed it. Oh, what's he doing? Oh, yep, max out the Geminate. Okay. Alright, how is the Legion Commander doing? She actually has Sentry Wards. Not much items on her, though. At one point, personal attack would be really good, but instead, she's going for a max out Moment of Courage build. That's not something you see very often. Caught between three enemies. Can she make that alive? There's a hookshot available. Looks like she'll just be okay. Is it just me, or does it feel like the Dire side have expended a lot of energy in the bomb lane, and more people are coming bomb lane? It's just jumping on her. Again, no personal attack really limits her ability to stay alive. And yeah, there we go. Nice dodge, moving to the side. Oh wow, ultimate used here by the Enigma just to try to get this kill on the Crystal Maiden. I mean, come on, the Crystal Maiden, the one hero who's been doing pretty crappily. And personally, and time. What's the Moment of Courage? Overwhelming Oz. Then I always forget the name of this build. She has duel available. She should probably try to duel him. She's still standing in this smoke. Can she get the kill? Nope, she can't. Clockwork. Able to help out. Meanwhile, Nyx Assassin's still around. Does have his image if he wants to use it. They should be able to see them though. Ricky pinging them out like crazy. And who are they going to go for? They need to be very careful around here. And nice ultimate coming out from the Pudge. Ooh, nice grab. Can he throw it? No, still no Mass Serpent Wars coming out for some reason. Mass Serpent Wars now being thrown. And Nyx Assassin with that beautiful double stun. Looks like they should be able to clean house here. They are able to get them both. And for some reason, Weaver decided not to use Time Lapse just now. Time Lapse overrated, I always said. Why stay alive when you can die? I mean, is that how the game goes? Fire Recap shows a huge advantage for the Radiant side. Of course, it doesn't show the couple of kills that they got earlier, but still, good advantage for the Radiant from that fight. They did lose a tower, but they pretty much wiped out the enemy team in return, so no big deal for them. One of the good things about personal attack is that also you can remove things like frostbite stuns from Tiny, and you know, a lot of good stuff come out from it if he gets it, but he decides not to for some reason. I don't know. How's Enigma doing? Enigma looks like he's gonna rush Axums this game. And he also has the weirdest skill build of all. He's maxed out Midnight Pulse over Demonic Conversion, which is good for farming, over Malphite, which is good for fighting. I mean, Midnight Pulse is nice and all, but... he wants to combine it with the items. Oh, well, looks like he won't be able to combine much because he's probably dead. Pudge Hook misses, and Midnight Pulse comes out. Could he actually survive? No, there's no way he's going to make it out alive. Either shot comes out. Can he get a nice double kill? Again, no time lapse being used by the Weaver. Good dual victory coming out. Crystal Maiden still dancing. Can she actually get a couple of kills out of this? She does. Holy shit! Crystal Maiden has gone from 0 and 5 to 4 and 6. It's amazing. This is why I prefer... I don't say I would prefer, but this is why the sort of lower tier games are so enjoyable, because you really never know what's going to happen. Crystal Maiden was absolutely worthless, you know, for the first five deaths of the game, and now suddenly she got a triple kill. That's it. The game has completely has done a complete 180 on her. You know, look at this. First, it was even, then the Dire were winning, then the Radiant were winning, then the Dire were winning, then the Radiant were winning. Same thing with the experience. Oh, actually, experience has been more one-sided, though. Oh my god. Legion Commander, still no items on this person. She's had the same items for the last few minutes now. What about Xiao Shaman? Oh, Xiao Shaman. He's got a lot of Sentry Wars, a lot of Observe Awards. That's good for the team. Oh, Ricky Mar walks into them. Can he get a good grab? They do get a good grab. Weavers here. They threw out the stun. Nice. What do you call them? Serpent Wars coming out. They'll probably be able to kill the Xiao Shaman, but Xiao Shaman gets a nice double kill here. Pudges around, but it's gonna be pretty hard to hook someone in this situation. Come on! That was an easy hook, bro. And he does miss it. Crystal Maiden does have the Blink Dagger, but still choosing to walk in. Enigma has the ultimate. Is he gonna use it? Ultimate coming out. Oh, Crystal Maiden throws out her ultimate. Nice hook comes out. I was about to... Sorry, I sneezed. My bad. Pudge, will he be able to make that of this situation alive? I don't think. Nub, he's dead. But he does commit suicide, so at least he doesn't lose much. And Nyx Assassin actually trapped by the Serpent War. Sorry about the sneeze just now. It really came all of a sudden for me. Anyway, does he have the black hole? So yeah, he's maxing out Midnight Pulse so that he gets a strong black hole when he gets his Aghanims. Which is okay, but... I don't know. Doesn't feel like it's really necessary. I mean, Midnight Pulse, the damage does... You know, the scale is not that great. I mean, the damage increases by less than double from max to, you know, from level 1 to level 4. So it's not the best thing to max out first, in my opinion, of course. Although I have a pretty strong opinion on this one. Oh, okay. Is he going to go in? He walks into it. I think he wanted to use his black hole. There we go. Black hole finally expands. Hookshot comes out. He might be able to save his teammate here. The problem is that he's stuck in the Midnight Pulse. They are able to get the kill. Should have considered using the Blade Mail a bit sooner, bro. But they are going to trade 1-for-1. Maybe 2-for-1, looks like. And Shaman is going to fall. Tiny, did he just remove aggro? That's a pretty advanced skill to know. That's what he did. That's pretty nice. All right, Legion Commander is here. That does not interest. She jumps in, just walks by. Sold most of her items, actually. She had the Ring of Basilisk. She had the Stout Shield. Sold most of it so she can get a Javelin. All right. I swear, the thing's coming out from both sides. Tiny, looks like he's about to get his Blink Dagger. Could just sell the Tangos. Not sure if he's been having the Agility Threads for a while or if they're new, but either way, they're pretty sucky. Strike Threads are fine, but Agility Threads on a Tiny? I mean, come on. Oh, Crystal Maiden. He does have a Blink Dagger. So far, I don't think I've seen her blink, but that might have been my bad. Oh, Weaver's cut out. Weaver, probably the nice Crystal Maiden jump in with the ultimate. Beautiful job, Crystal Maiden. Making me, like, feel bad about every bad thing I said about her. How is Pudge doing? Pudge, oh dear. Oh, nice hook. And remember, Weaver does have his ultimate. Actually uses it for once to stay alive. And Pudge, meanwhile, falls in the end. Weaver, you're kind of... Oh, there we go. Was he going to go for Lincoln Sphere? Oh, Lincoln Sphere. Okay. Oh, Crystal Maiden deciding that she's too good for this world, wants to commit suicide. Weaver also not enjoying life too much. What about... Oh, actually, no, wait. Weaver does die in the end. And Ricky Mar is going to make that alive. Meanwhile, Pudge, looks like he must have landed the hook for once. And can he do anything else? Can he land two hooks in a row? Two hooks. That's twice as much skill. Nope. Nothing's gonna happen. Oh, wow. Okay, let's look at the graphs again. Radiant's favor, Dire's favor, Radiant's favor, Dire's favor. Now it's gonna shoot back up again. Oh wait, actually they might be able to get a kill here. Nice duel coming out. And winner, winner, chicken dinner. 20 damage now for the Legion Commander. Does anyone else? Weaver actually has 10 damage. That's actually pretty... That's more scary than the Weaver's 20, if you ask me. And Rikimon also has 10, so... I mean, she's given just as much as she's taken. That's not a situation you want to be in. Still waiting for that Goldgraf to update. Okay. So, Javelin, I assume this is going to be a Basher. Probably going to be a Basher. Still no points to burst the attack. Very odd, Shell Shaman has tons of wards, like 4 observers, 3 sentries. The guy is still thinking though. He's like, I want to make sure every ward I plant counts. You know, I'm going for maximum efficiency, so I'm going to keep the wards until I absolutely have to use them or something like that. I don't really know what he's thinking. He has a Yule Scepter, alright. Interesting item. Good, I mean, it gives him a good amount of movement speed. Yule Scepter gives you about the same movement speed as a boot. So, pretty impressive. Enigma. Okay. Can he grab anyone? He has a Yule Scepter, by the way. Nice hook coming out. Beautiful. Look at that long shackle. Could use Yule's on someone, but nope. Needs to be a bit careful. A lot of bugs coming out. Finally, she gets rest of the attack. But is this going to be enough? Nice hook! Punch! With the plays. I already used. And Enigma does have his black hole. Black hole! Beautiful black hole on 2 people. Canceled. And how's Xiao Shaman gonna survive this? He does have a hex. Hex not coming up for God knows what reason. Enigma, let's throw out the midnight pulse. This is actually very dangerous because they're all trapped inside. And can he get the kill on this guy? Yeah, looks like he's gonna get the kill. Nice job by Enigma. That midnight pulse. Here's the thing. I was approaching this game from a 4K perspective, but I should have approached this game from the trench perspective. That's why the midnight pulse is so good. You know, now it all makes sense to me. That's why we're going. Oh, okay. Oh god. Next assassin, where has he been, by the way? He's just been quietly bottom lane, just doing his own thing. I haven't noticed. Has this guy like been involved? Alright, nice. She's losing more damage than she's dealing. And Dagon, gets the kill. I'm still surprised that this guy is not using Spite Carapace more. But good kill by him, able to kill the Crystal Maiden. And gold. Gold climbing up, like we said, now it's going to Radiant's favor. You know how this game goes. Everyone takes turns. I don't think anyone's actually buying TP scrolls, by the way. There's literally no... The Legion Commander has 2 TP scrolls. That's nice. So out of the Radiant side, 20% of them invested the TP scroll strategy. Earn comes out on the punch. I like that item. Let's look at the Team Dire, by the way. Team Dire. Phase Boots is fine. I prefer personally Power Treads myself, but that's definitely nothing wrong with it. Legion Commander does have a toss. Oh, right. What's gonna happen here? Okay, some damage coming out. She could dive, but decides not to. Alright. Crystal Maiden, what's she gonna go for? Looks like she's gonna be a Shiva's. Wow, straight up Shiva's got a recipe. I like that she has 3 slots that are completely empty, but doesn't want to fill them up with anything like a magic wand or an extra bracer. Nope, just we're going straight Shiva's, boys. Straight Shiva's is what I want. Tiny does have the Bleak Dagger. I'm not sure when he bought, but should have had for a while. 3 points of Cracking Exterior early on, that's not something we see very often. Most people max out the Avalanche and the Toss for that huge combination damage, but he decides that Cracking Exterior is what he needs. Well, which is kind of ironic because the enemy team doesn't have many right click apart from the Legion Commander. Most people will just keep their distance and use magic, so... I won't say wasted, but I won't say useful either. Oh, Pudge. Oh well, that was wishful thinking. Enigma's here. Enigma, black hole. Nope, no black hole available yet. Rikimar, what's he gonna go for? Skull Bashers, the recipe first. Actually, he has it if he wants to. Oh, come on, you can do it! Come on. Does he have an ulti charge? He does have an ulti charge. He can just use it. Besides, could have gotten the kill. Come on, man. I believe in. Forget. Reaver needs to be very careful. They do have a lot of situations. Wow, what? Just randomly used himself. Meanwhile, Clockwork was able to kill the next assassin. I think he was able to kill him. Rocket Flare got the kill. Oh, big jump in by the Crystal Maiden. Can they interrupt her? Nope, they just decided to let her do her ultimate. I mean, they... Oh, well, actually, they didn't have anything to interrupt. Well, Pudge had his ultimate and a hook. And I think Xiao Shaman could have... could have used the tech. Oh, Black Hole coming out. And might be able to get the kill. He's able to get the kill on the Weaver, but that's about it. So, team wipe for the Weaver. Crystal Maiden getting ultra killed. I didn't realize how strong Crystal Maiden was, because if no one interrupts her ultimate, she really can do the most damage in the game thanks to it. I think like when they calculated whose spells do the most damage, we found that Crystal Maiden's ultimate does the most damage if she's allowed to just, you know, dance the whole time. And they're really letting her dance. They're like, we don't want to be rude. I should have switched to Netherworld a long time ago, but Netherworld, really not surprising. Legion Commander's bottom in the list, and Crystal Maiden's number 4. Typical, I expected as much. Bashar's coming out on the Ricky. What I like about this game is that people have so many empty slots that they're not using, but they're like, I don't want to fill them up. I don't want to buy too many items. I think my hero's movement speed is reduced if we fill up their inventory. I mean, Weaver has, Crystal Maiden has 2 slots empty, Tiny has 2, Ricky Mara has 3 slots. And it's like, hey, buy a CB scroll, you know? Buy an Ironwood branch, I don't know. Nyx is actually okay. Pudge has 2 slots empty. Enigma is fine. Legion Commander has 2 slots empty. I mean, people are walking around with all this empty space. Like, I mean, bro, fill it up. You know? Your movement speed doesn't decrease if your inventory is full or something. Shadow Shaman, tons of words. I feel like this guy should have realized by now that you really just get a gem. Secondly, I mean, he's warding, but the enemy team doesn't really care a bit about wards, so I feel like they should have the advantage. Oh, nice hook shot coming in. Can they get the kill? Crystal Maiden for what's not jumping. Ooh, beautiful. And can he actually... Nice Serpent Wards! Right in the middle of the cog. Can they get anything? Does kill the Crystal Maiden, who has been dominating the game, apparently. And can he get more out of this? Can he get more out of this? Probably can kill one. Yep, kills one of them. Can he get more? No. If he had thrown out the Serpent Wards earlier, he might have been able to get a triple kill. But, you know, a bit of a... delay, I guess, or something. Still gets a nice double kill for himself, and it seems like the advantage is still in terms for the die, but I think that's just because they only count one death instead of both. By the way, magic wand is really a lot better than magic stick. Most people should know that. Gold graph, about topsy-turvy, as expected. Now, let's look at the two teams, and let's decide, let's try and make the bet on who we think is going to win. On the Radiant side, we have Legion Commander, who's so far been somewhat ineffective. She's 0-6. So I don't think she's going to do much for the rest of the game. Shadow Shaman has been pretty damn good. 8-6. Could use his Yule Scepter. He has 6 Observer Wards, by the way. 6 Observer Wards. I don't know. He's collecting interest on them or something. Enigma has thrown out a few good black holes, but really, he's going for the Refresher build. No Blink Dagger, because apparently you don't need it. Nyx Assassin is 4-5, he's done okay. Pudge has missed a lot of hooks, he's died as much as he's contributed. So, on the Raiden side, they have a good Shaman, they have a good Enigma, decent Nyx and Pudge, and so far Legion Commander has had no positive effect on the game whatsoever. Let's look at the Dire side. Clockwork, he's done okay, I've seen him do a couple of good hook shots. Oh, can he get him? Nice grab, and they're gonna get this kill. Crystal Maiden is probably gonna jump and do her ultimate base. Huge miss! From the swarm. And Crystal Maiden just challenged her. Oh, wait, actually, Black Hole does come out. Weaver is able to kill the Nyx Assassin. They are able to drop the Crystal Maiden for once. Can they do any more? Looks like the Sentry. Oh, wait, there, here it is. The Sentry. And can they get more out of this? Shell Shaman is going to fall 3-4-2 trades for now. And they're going to go for the Enigma next. And they do end up. They don't need to do anything. So yeah, Clockwork has done pretty well. Weaver is starting to pick up. I don't see what's the point of Lincoln Sphere. Actually, Lincoln Sphere is not that bad like this game. I was going to say something, but actually he's made the right choice. It blocks Duel, it blocks Hex, Aether Shock Shackles, it blocks Malphus, it blocks Mana Burn, and it also blocks Dismember. So there's a lot of good stuff you can block with Lincoln's this game. So I think he made the right choice. Crystal Maiden, she is very hot and very cold at the same time. She's very hot because she's a blonde, she's a busty blonde, but sometimes she's very cold. She just seems to, you know, like in the early game, she kind of died a lot for no reason. I didn't really get that. Yeah, but her ultimates so far have been game changers. Tiny has so far been pretty damn ineffective, I'd say. Ricky Maru has done better, but I think it's mostly because of the fact that he's been Envy and they haven't been able to see him. Oh dear, okay. Enigma needs to be careful. Needs to be very careful. Oh, they see the Pudge. Pudge hook misses between three people. How do you miss three people when they're just right next to each other? I'm not sure. Oh, hookshot comes out. Also misses. The skill shots in this game have been so interesting, so to speak. Oh, nice. Ty's going to get the kill. Oh, forget. Toss someone, maybe? And finally, Swarm comes up. They might be able to get the kill on the Pudge. He tosses the Weaver. Okay. And what's going to happen now? Looks like literally the enemy team is helping him out. And this member comes out, but like we said, the Link is actually pretty good this game, and they're gonna get the kill. Meanwhile, though, Crystal Maiden does fall. Crystal Maiden is so far the most dangerous enemy on the Dire side. She's also getting very close to that Shiva's guard. And Weaver gonna go for the Deso build. So far, Weaver's build has been spot on. His skill build was pretty terrible, but his item build, very nice. Very nice indeed. Next Assassin does have the Force Staff. Force Staff actually is really good to push people out of the smoke screen, to push people out of cogs, out of Crystal Maiden's ultimate. Oh, they're gonna jump on him, and they miss the hook shot. Okay, false alarm. He's fine. Actually, even if they caught him, he could have just Force Staffed himself. But the question is, would he have done it? Oh wow, stun comes out. Can he get Force Staff? Oh, forget it. Legion Commander looks like she's probably gonna die as well. Oh, nice jump in by the Shadow Shaman. Can he do anything out? Lightning comes out, gets one kill. Can he get another one? Can he grab anyone? He does have Magic Stick. No need to use Magic Stick either. I swear that they have items and abilities that they can use, but they just don't use them. I mean, what's the point of having Force Staff if you're gonna fight inside the smoke screen? Or having a Magic Stick? If he had used Magic Stick and used himself, he would have survived. But he decided, I don't wanna. I'm sick of this cruel world, and they just die for no reason. I don't know. But still, it's been a very interesting game. I mean, I love these kind of games where, you know, you don't know who's gonna do what. Where's the screw up gonna come from? It's all a mystery to us. Oh dear. Enigma number one, net worth, followed by the Weaver. Then we have the Clockwork. Shadow Shaman is number 4, Tiny is number 5, Crystal Maiden is number 6, she used to be number 4, and we have Refresher now up on the Enigma. Now, I don't want to be mean, but we have rarely seen that good black hole from him, so I doubt we're going to see two good black holes in a row. I feel like he really should have gotten the Blink Dagger. Oh, nice. Time for that big black hole. Nice ultimate coming out. Can we get a good black hole? Nope. Cog's out. A black hole just like Crystal Maiden. No problem. Refresher, maybe? Refresher? Black hole again? Black hole comes out. Now on the clockwork. Oh, no, cancels it. It was actually the rocket, what's it called? Battery assault that stopped him. Okay, alright. No problem. No problem. What's he gonna go for next? Radiance on the clockwork. I think that's a pretty good choice. I mean, there's not that much right click, but, you know, you're tanking, you're alive. You might as well go for Radiance. The Midnight Pulse. Oh, okay. He's gonna throw him in the air. Can he do anything? Grabs him. Barely at the edge of the Midnight Pulse, but not enough. I could have used his Hex, but no Hex is coming out. Okay, can we get the kill here? Hex is available. No, nope, doesn't have Hex. Sorry, Shackles is available. Does have the Magic Stick. Alright, looks like the fight is mostly over, I think. Neither team investing in a mech, because who cares about supporting or healing their own team? Shadow Shaman. Now with 5 Observer Wards. At what point of the game do you guys think he's going to actually plant them? He has 5 Observer Wards in his stash, and there's 1 Observer Ward on the actual map. I don't get why that happens exactly. Alright, Ricky Mara going to go for that big jump in. Can they... And now they're going to jump in. Can they stun? Actually misses everyone. What is up with Enigma? Oh, now he's moving. And just a weird combination of mess ups coming out here. Tiny does have is haste up, but come on, Shackle, anything? Does he have any skills? Oh, he does, but Weaver's here. Okay, maybe they can get the Weaver instead. Hex, Shackle, Hex. Oh no, decides not to use it, and the stun misses from the next assassin. Of course we'd miss that last minute stun, why not? Okay, mana burn comes out. Something's going on. And that's about it for this fight, I'd say. Oh, can I get a kill on Nyx Assassin? Misses the stun again. And looks like the Weaver is just kind of walking to Midnight Pulse. Don't try not to do that, man. Shiva's got up on the Crystal Maiden. I'm not really sure what's the point. It's nice damage, but there's no physical right click coming out from the Radiant side that needs to be stopped. Legion Commander actually going for the MKB. Holy shit! Not even Basher. MKB. Straight MKB. I've never seen this. She goes Boots, MKB. Like that, like there's no chill for this Legion Commander. She starts out, she's like, I think I need boots. People are like, hey, that's a good idea. And I think next I need to go for MKB because of the evasion. Well, actually, there is the miss from the smoke screen, but I feel like that's kind of a danger by itself. And she's dead. Rikimaru has the Sanj, so starting to fill up those slots. What about Tiny's? Tiny's making that. Aghanim's actually has it if he wants to buy it. Crystal Maiden has the Shiva's Guard. We actually talked about this, so no need to go over it again. Weaver, Deso is available. Deso, really good this game against all these squishy, low armor heroes. Clockwork, building into the Radiance. Still surprised that he goes Radiance Recipe first. I mean, don't most people just go for the Relic? What's the point of having a Recipe? Pudge has had zero item progress for a long time. Actually, is Pudge even in this game? I mean, I haven't seen him do it. Oh, we have engagement. Forget about that. Nyx Assassin is good for. If only he had an item that could take him out of the smoke. Nice black hole coming in. He actually jumps into it. And can they do more hits to do it? Is the second black hole coming? Second black hole! Oh, well, actually, forget. Barrier Assault cancels that. And finally, the Xiao Shaman throws out his ultimate. And looks like they might be able to trade evenly here. Can they get the kill? Nope. Xiao Shaman ultimate came out so late in that fight. And meanwhile, yep, fight recap shows that it is going to be a huge Dire victory. Well, actually, not huge. I mean, they trade 3-for-2, but they are able to kill Enigma, who is the most farmed hero. Nyx Assassin, so far, has bought this 4-step, and I have not seen him use it once. And huge creep wave coming in bottom. Legion Commander could consider farming, but no. I need to get those pesky neutral creeps. A tower was destroyed by the Dire. Meanwhile, bomb lane is being pushed. Nyx Assassin also ignores the large amount of gold and experience available for him here and decides that no, top is where he's needed. Legion Commander still a bit drunk or something. Gotta get that MKB gold, ladies and gentlemen. She could have just farmed it all here, by the way. One overwhelming odds would have just killed them all. Meanwhile, Nyx Assassin is taking a bit of damage here. Oh, Legion Commander really, really going for this. I mean, she has no TP scrolls, so she can't come and assist her team. Nyx Assassin is dead. Also, he has this ability called Spike Carapace. I don't know if you guys know what it does. I'll explain what it does because we've never seen it this game. Spike Carapace, if you're attacked, reflects the damage, so if you're hit by like a massive finger of death, you actually finger them back, and also stuns them. It's a very good ability. I've heard that's like one of the best ways to improve with Nyx is mastering how you use it. So it's a really good skill, just saying. It's a very good skill. Legion Commander has boots and MKB. Have you ever heard of description when a hero is like, hey, what does this hero have? Oh, he has boots. Oh, and what else? MKB. Because those two things go together very well. Xiao Shaman, meanwhile, is able to kill the Rikimaru. Xiao Shaman. No, he's fine. He's good. He actually almost has his Aghanim. And Rikimaru just bought back for no reason. He buys back. Okay, he's TPing. Oh, they're going to go for the GG push, people. They're just chilling. Pudge. Oh, Pudge has abandoned, definitely. Yeah, he has no gold on him. When did he abandon, anyway? Doesn't say. Well, one thing that Radiant, his friends could do is sell his items for more gold, but I mean, they'd each get like 1.2k gold, which is gonna be pretty damn useful. Oh, they okay, jump in by the Rikimaru, and Black Hole is not available actually, they can't use it. But can they get the kill on anyone? Nope, they're all just walking into the smoke screen like it's candy or something. Just because it looks like. What's the name of that thing called? Oh, forget. Okay, Enigma's here. Does have one black hole available. Black hole is expanded, and Tiny just walks into it. No big deal. And actually, he just stops the Black Hulk server in the middle. And can they get the kill on the Rikimaru? Oh, nice dual scepter used by the Shadow Shaman, keeping him alive. And he just draws his ultimate very early. Good ultimate. What can they do next? Enigma does use his refresher. And it's going to be a big Black Hulk number two. And huge Black Hulk coming out. Will what's his face go into it? Weaver, of course, doesn't use his time lapse because why would he? And Enigma, massive plays coming out from this guy. This guy's hole is so huge. It's amazing. Fire recap shows Enigma doing most of the work. Actually, the Shadow Shaman's wards did so much damage in that fight. Jump in. Enigma? I think. Come on, Enigma. Come on, bro. You can do it. I believe in you. Stun. Nice. And actually, I think Enigma's gonna win this fight. Dude, he's not AFK. He's DC'd. Hey! Hey, what's wrong with tranny porn? Ain't nothing wrong with it, let me tell you that. You know? It's kind of like that transition phase when a person's not sure what they like yet. Surprisingly, mid-tower for the Dire is still up, whereas Dire have taken all the outer towers for the Radiant. In fact, the only tower they have left is the Tier 3 and, of course, the base towers. Whereas the Radiant have only taken 3 towers themselves. Not that much. So now we know how it's 4-on-5. It's a Radiant to R4. Legion Commander. Not sure what she's doing. Run. Oh, Duel comes out. Could use her illusion. There we go. Does she actually have enough damage to get the kill? No, she doesn't. And Crystal Maiden. Could have used her Bite, but decided not. Not sure why she'd use Shiva's Guard over Bite, when Bite is sort of the better ability. And all the MKB in the world couldn't have saved Legion Commander. And like I said, she has empty slots. This is so inefficient when you walk around with just empty slots for no reason, but whatever. Looks like someone's gonna go. Is it going to be? Yep, it's gonna be the Weaver. He's gonna go for the Butterfly. And nice ultimate coming out from the Shao Sham. Look at the damage that's gonna come out once this thing's down. Yeah, it's a huge amount of damage. I think he's level 6, yeah, level 3 with Aghanims. Each one does like 130 damage, yeah. Huge mana cost, by the way. And they are able to clear it out, but did do a good amount of damage. I don't know if it was worth it, because now you don't have your ultimate available for a while, but still, it is something. Also, like I said, if the person who sent this, I think, is probably a Radiant player, make sure you sell all the items that you have for anyone who's AFK, because then you get all their gold. Nyx Assassin, they go on level 2. These assassins' items have really halted, haven't they? And yep, this is what I expected. Look at those squiggly lines. Wee 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 wee. Oh god. I actually can't say I've been taking this game too seriously, which I apologize for if the guy expected like some in-depth analysis. I mean, the game is kinda, I don't know what's the word for it, but it's kind of clowny, this game. At least in my opinion. It's like everyone's misplaying so much. And looks like Enigma has a point of stick staff. Oh, it's an Octarine Core, okay. Really good for him. If he can catch a few people in this black hole, he can do a lot. Octarine Core will basically just fill him up. Oh, Ricky, does he want to go for round 2 against Enigma? Enigma does have both of his holes available. Oh, okay. Goes for him. Not really who you want to go for, Ricky. And will he throw out Black Hole? He does throw out Black Hole, but could they actually see him? Is he Envy? Do they see him? He actually doesn't reveal himself. Black Hole was expanded for almost nothing. He didn't use that refresher fast, so at least he's going to have an ultimate available now. Is he going to go for more? Ooh, second Black Hole? Beautiful, second Black Hole is really good. And Tiny just walks into... Why do you do that, Tiny? Tiny just walks into Black Hole like it's his salvation. Oh, come on. Tiny with those black holes. Dude. This is like the fourth time we see him. He sees a black hole and he's like, I gotta get into that. It's not tranny porn, dude. It's a black hole. Just keep your distance sometimes. Oh, dear. Radiance is up on the clockwork. This will disable all the blink daggers that are on the Nyx's. Oh wait, no blink. On the Enigma. Oh wait, no blink. On the. Oh, also no blink. But Legion Commander has no blink on her either. So, it would disable a blink dagger, if anyone had a blink dagger. Weaver so far has refused to time lapse because he doesn't want to. Time lapse, overrated skill. I mean, why would you want to time lapse when you can choose not to time lapse? He's died 10 times, of which 5 of them he could have just time lapsed out of it. MVP so far of this game is really a toss up between the Shadow Shaman and the Enigma. Enigma has thrown out those amazing black holes, but Shadow Shaman has done also a lot of work. He may not, his job may have been less flashy, but that doesn't really detract from the fact that he's done a very good job. I like what Shao Shaman has done this game. You know, it is he's done some good stuff. A nice Octarine Core coming out. Gonna really reduce the cooldown on all of his spells, but most importantly, Black Hole's cooldown is gonna be a bit more acceptable. Ooh, they need the gem. They need the gem so badly. He's gonna try to get that double smoke. Can he get it? Oh, Ricky, meanwhile, kills the Legion Commander. Nothing. No big deal. Oh, actually, I thought this was Ricky. This is actually Crystal Maiden. Ricky or Crystal Maiden, they both look alike to me. Hard to disable the Enigma with his Lincoln Sphere. And what do they want? Almost gonna. Okay, they're gonna go for it. Radiance does come out. Nice Crystal Maiden ultimate. Can the Malphus was already used. And Shackles. Oh, wow. Huge miss on that hook shot. And the Enigma can't actually do anything. He is healing somehow, but. Okay, can they do anything here? Hookshot is available in a few seconds. Is he gonna hookshot again? Nope. Just not going to. Needs to be careful though. If he hookshots the Enigma, he might actually kill himself now. He's gonna be fine. 3-for-nothing trade so far. And might be a 4-for-nothing trade if they can get this Enigma kill. Looks like they should be able to. If only he had an ability that allows him to move fast. There we go. Shiguchi finally used. And stun does come out. Lands for once in this game. And they are gonna kill this Enigma. Enigma giving up a wicked 6 streak. Huge kill coming out on this Enigma. And fight recap shows a massive victory for the Dire side. 5k gold swing, 7.5k experience. And they are going to try to go for this base. And remember, they have a very good base breaking lineup. They do have, oh well, actually, they don't have any creeps nearby, is the problem. Also, they really should just go get this range racks and get out, because they're not going to be able, because this tower is going to take forever for them to beat down, and they're just sticking to it, guys. They're sticking to it. It's like there are racks exposed here. There's also racks exposed here, but they're like, nope, we want this tower. This tower is taking for absolutely forever to beat up. All right, this tower, that tower was has so far been more useful than the Legion Commander. And Tanya's like, man, I did enough work for once. I'm just gonna go back. Oh, and finally, when the racks are exposed, they decide to leave. Oh, okay. Raxus, maybe. It's amazing that now, at this point of the game, they still don't have a gym. Okay, come on, Legion Commander. Is she gonna do it? The Legion Commander so far with shit for farm, really. MKB boots. Oh, big ultimate coming out here. And Crystal Maiden doing that big spinny thing. And can they get the kill? Oh, they're just gonna spare the Shadow Shaman. Gonna go for the Raxus. Can they actually make it this? Oh, they're gonna go for. I mean, there's 3 sets of Raxus exposed, people. Just let the guy die, alright? Let the guy run away. Sorry, not let the guy die. Okay, meanwhile, Clockwork. He's just kind of doing Clockwork things. Yeah, okay. What do I want to buy? What do I want to buy? What's going on in this game? Oh, okay, Enigma! Big black hole time! Oh, okay, one person. Enigma! Second big black hole time! Come on, Enigma! Yes! Enigma! You can do it! Oh, 2 Midnight Pulses stacked on top of each other. Can they get one kill? Can you get more? Come on, you can do it! You can do it! You get the kill! Nice job, Enigma! Hookshot on absolutely nothing, because he sucks. And Enigma? Can you get Enigma! Triple kill! Come on, Enigma, you can do it! You can get him! You can get him! Ricky has bought back in the game. Oh, wow, that's scary. Oh, well, try not to walk into cock so much, Enigma. And, can I do anything? No? Tiny? Tiny, he's like, there's no black hole I can walk into, so what am I supposed to do? He's kind of lost. You know, he's lost. There's nothing for him to do. There's no black hole to walk into, no bad play to make. And Legion Commander's still building something. I don't know what the hell it is. I think it's a Deso, but at this point, who cares? She's 3 and 13. Enigma single-handedly. Oh, not single-handedly, sorry. I have to give credit again. Oh, no. Enigma, don't die. Enigma, my personal favorite in this game. Come on, Enigma. Oh, Duel comes out. Oh, nice Duel. The winner! Nygma does fall in the end, but it's okay. Shadow Shaman does have his ultimate, but kind of use it later. Oh, dude, you could have used yourself and survived. Oh, well. And... it's okay. A victory for the Radiant, I'd say. They didn't have to buy back. Oh, I don't think Shadow Shaman needed to die, though. I mean, he could have just yield himself and survived, but... decides not to. Looks like they're pushing in top lane by the dire creep wave. The melee damage is not so important. Oh, but look at all the, look at those range creeps going at it. Holy crap. And Midnight Pulse is thrown. Look how much he can just heal to full just like that. Yeah. Actually, though, this is just from his refresh and all that other stuff. But the damage from the melee racks is going to heal. The range rack takes minor damage, not big, no big deal. Weaver actually goes for the butterfly. Odd that the only person who gets BKB in this game is the Crystal Maiden. She's going to go for Agnum's next. Okay. I accept that. I'm cool with that. What's going to happen next? What are they going to go for? Pings come out on Roshan, who so far has been a non-factor this game. What's the gold graph looking like? And then we go down for the Dire victory. Then we go up for the Radiant. Then we go back down for the Dire. I'm telling you, this game has... There is no rhyme or reason in this game. This, you know, you're better off betting on Russian roulette than on who's going to win in this game. But my bet is that it's going to be a Radiant victory, simply because I feel like it's the Enigma who submitted this game as a replay. Just judging by how he's played and how the title is 4v5, so I assume it's Enigma. The Punch doesn't look like it. Doesn't say he's a bandit though, so maybe they can't sell his stuff. But then again, he wouldn't be having gold if they can, you know, if they can't sell his stuff. Weird. Would you command 66 damage? Has envy. Ships that sail through the night, as they say. She just walks past through the Rikimaru. Rikimaru versus Legion Commander. The matchup we've all been waiting for. Oh, let's look at this one. Oh, dear. Oh, look at this. Look at this production quality. And oh, she's dead before I can do much. And in the meantime, though, they are able to kill a Crystal Maiden who has the BKB but decides not to use it. Oh, well, Weaver going for this. Black Hole comes out and Weaver's dead. Let's have the... Oh, wow. They do lose the bottom range racks, though, in return, though. They might actually... I think they also lost the melee racks as well. Wow. This is a pretty scary trade. Oh, okay. Black Hole number two. Also catches two people. Huge damage. And there's going to get a nice double kill for the Enigma. Hey, what's going to get this game next? Probably one of the worst countries. Oh, okay. I'll look into it. Let's see. They do lose the bottom racks. That's really not what you want. How about top lane? Sorry if I missed out here on your chat. I don't even know if you're here, actually. It only shows one person's here, that's me. Oh, well. Let's focus on this amazing game. They lose the bottom racks, they lose the mid racks, their top racks are exposed. I mean, it should be a pretty easy, you know, dire victory at this stage. But who knows? Tiny. Who's gonna go? Alright, Tiny. How is he? And... nope, it's just going to make that fine. But yeah, sure, I'll check that game out and see if I can download it. A hell of an elk. But this game, this Enigma, 24-9, MVP by far. Doesn't mean Shadow Shaman, what's wrong with you, man? Your base is being pushed in. How's the tower? And one thing I'll say to this Enigma player is, dude, get a Blink Dagger. It's a really good item. And oh, she used her BKB, and she just, for some reason, just decided to cancel it at some point. I don't know why she would do that. That was weird as hell. And Radiance is gonna burn him down, gonna cause a bit of trouble for him. Needs to consider using. Okay, nice. Can they get the kill on the Enigma? Enigma so far has been doing so well by himself. Enigma! No! Rip Enigma. Ripperino and Pepperino, as they say. Or is it Pepperoni and Pepperoni? I don't know. Anyway, doesn't matter. Looks like the Dire are going to go for the GG push. It's happening, boys. Enigma, does he have buyback? Does Enigma have buyback? Oh, it doesn't have buyback. Actually, no one has buyback. Nobody buyback in this game is a commodity that nobody really cares for. Dire side could just go top, just end this. I mean, it's literally 3-on-5 right now. Literally 3-on-5. You know, Legion command. Sorry, this guy is not around. This guy's dead. Come on, Dire. Come on, Dire. I mean, if they want to win, but they're taking their time. They're taking their time. Enigma needs time to respond. Legion commander still building that deso. That's gonna take forever. Oh, Tiny just kind of standing there. Duel just gets dueled for no reason. Smoke maybe comes out. Okay, Smoke. Nice kill. Two kills come out. And it looks like it's going to be a Dire victory. I really thought it was going to be a Radiant victory, but... I mean, what could they do? Poor guys, huh? Honestly, very good job coming out from the Shadow Shaman, from the Enigma. But not enough to carry the team. I like this game. I thought it was a lot of fun. I had fun casting this game, that's the thing. I had a lot of fun casting it. Thank you for watching if you did. And tell me if you enjoyed this game. I'm going to go do this cast for Still Banned Don'ts, I think. Thank you for watching.